Hola!
Hi!
This is our February Love Month book talk.
I'm Bree.
I'm Taylor, and we're going to be talking about Amy and Roger's Epic Detour by Morgan Matson. There will be spoilers in this, so if you haven't read it, don't continue watching.
Yeah, go read it first.
Yeah. Let's see if I can raise this volume somehow.
Can you hear me?
Aha! Is that increasing the volume? Can you turn your volume up?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's better. I was like, my volume's to the max, but anyway. So, general thoughts?
I liked it more than I thought I would. What about you?
I liked it too, but I expected something different, I have to say.
Yeah, it was kind of slowish, I guess.
It was sad for me.
It was just kind of like, I don't know, strange. I liked the main character, though.
I did like the main character. I liked all the musical references. I thought that was great.
Oh, I didn't like that part, but other than that, I liked her.
Because you're a visual artist. I bet you if she was drawing or doing sketches or taking photography. She was taking photography.
Yeah, but like that just like, you know how the creative writers and the theater kids like take artsy pictures, it pisses me off so much. But that's what that felt like to me.
Just me.
I'm sorry. You guys get everything.
You could have auditioned for theater.
You guys got to see Adam Scott. We didn't.
I didn't get to see Adam Scott.
Really?
Only juniors and seniors in theater got to see Adam Scott. Yeah. So, you're bad.
Whatever.
Bitter.
But yeah, I liked the book more than I thought I would like it, but it was like kind of weird. The romance was okay, but like it was really expected because I obviously knew it was going to happen, but it was kind of like weird, I guess, when you're thinking about it, that it did happen.
Yeah, because at this one point, I thought that Amy was going to end up with that other guy.
Oh, the...
Leone, what's his name? Leonard, or Lucien.
Lucien, yeah.
Because all of a sudden they start making out, and like she's making discoveries and driving around him. I'm like, oh, maybe they'll be a thing.
Yeah, I was like kind of confused, I guess, during that. And like, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I'm like over a road trip, sort of.
No, this made me want to take a road trip.
I don't know. Like, I didn't really get the whole point of their road trip. Like, I liked it, but it was like, what are you guys doing? But I'm cynical, so maybe it was cute and romantic, and I'm just stupid. Oh my gosh, Taylor.
What?
I'm like chugging a gallon of water.
You are being cynical. I thought it was cute. I didn't want it to end, but like, it was
very making me mad.
What?
Her mom was making me mad.
Yeah, like the mom was doing all this stuff to mess up with her, and she's not even allowed to have one moment of grief or like
wrongdoing. The girl was literally in the car when her dad died. Like, cut her some slack. It's been 3 months.
And I mean, like, it's not like they were like doing drugs or something. Like, they were like just taking some more time exploring the world. Like, there was like no time rush.
You made me thirsty, so I'm going downstairs to get water.
I came prepared.
I'm, like, literally white on the screen.
That's because it's dark in your living place.
No, I'm just really pale.
Okay, you can keep talking, though.
What?
You can keep talking, though.
Oh, like you like so much like sound in your place. But anyway,
I'll shut the door.
No, you don't have to. Okay. Shut.
I said I'll shut the door to that room.
Yeah, I heard you. But I don't know. Some of like the relationship part felt very rushed at the end. I felt there needed to be at least a couple, some more time to explore from the makeout through Philadelphia.
Sorry. Carry this in the laptop upstairs. I'm sorry.
You do know that the water that you're pouring out is already cold, so there's really no use in having the ice in there.
I like ice.
Ugh, I hate ice.
Okay, I got this. I'm gonna do it.
What are you carrying in the other hand? A phone?
The water.
No, what? What are you?
Laptop. Laptop, it's really heavy.
You're gonna drop one of those things. It's gonna be hilarious.
No. Stop being mean. Oh, crap. Oh, man, I closed my door. I'm gonna open it with my foot.
Yes.
Okay. I'm in.
That's great, man. I mean, that's how you have to work a PVA. Like, a PVA, your hands are always full. You have to learn how to use your hands and feet.
Yeah. Especially, like, when you're a visual artist during portfolio review week. Oh, my God.
No, like, especially when you're a theater person and you're carrying, like, this huge a fourth of a quarter equals a foot model of the Denny stage for Soul of the 70s, and you're carrying two models, one for Act 1 and one for Act 2, in both hands with your laptop. And your purse. And your
3D classes. I had to carry around like 7 cardboard sculptures, a wire sculpture of the Titanic, and like 3 ceramics projects.
It'd be so much easier if this was a boarding school.
Yeah, I know.
But some people at the school kind of sketchy. I don't know if I want to live on campus.
Oh my gosh.
But I mean that's every place, you know. I guess. Except, you know, for schools that I'm interested in, like Harvard and Stanford and Yale and Georgetown and other colleges, because believe me, those colleges are very amazing, and I would appreciate a scholarship to go to them, and or another college if you would reach out to me, that's okay. I'd appreciate it.
I'm wearing a Harvard sweater, but honestly, most of the times I forget that it says Harvard because I just use it as a paint sweater.
You do know this is probably going to be looked at by colleges, right, Bree?
Well, I mean, my mom went there. It's just a big sweater that I like to wear. And I got paint on it once, so now I just use it all the time.
Oh, okay. So, what do you want to talk about first in particular?
Can we talk about Charlie?
Yeah, okay. He kind of got himself into some trouble.
Yeah. I kind of got confused sometimes because you know how sometimes it would go into flashbacks?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes I got confused about that, like what part was a flashback.
How are you confused? The headings told you what if it was a flashback or not.
Yeah, but you know whenever you're reading a book and I just always skip the heading.
See, now you can't do that. You have to be a good reader and read everything on the page.
I'm being intellectually lazy.
To be honest, I sometimes when I know I have to read the book, I'll skim all the stuff that's not spoken.
Yeah.
And then they'll mention something. I'm like, wait, what'd you mention that for? And then I have to go back and figure out what they were talking about.
Yeah, because like, I don't know, he like kind of confused me because I kept forgetting that they were twins.
Oh, yeah, I forgot that too. I thought he was younger for some reason.
I thought he was older, and then I was like, oh, wait, they're twins.
You thought he was older?
Yeah, I kept thinking he was older.
Why?
I don't know why, I just did.
Yeah, I don't know. But, yeah. If you are in a situation where you're like near in like the deep end of drugs, you should find assistance, talk to someone. anyone.
Yeah, probably a good idea.
But I don't know, this place where they were having him seemed kind of a little bit too aggressive when keeping out visitors.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I understand that, like, it's rehab, but I don't know, like.
Like, did the mom know that it was, like, that kind of a place?
But even if you're that aggressive, like, clearly you need to, like, prevent people from climbing into windows. Clearly you're not strict enough with windows. So,
yeah, did they, like, sneak out?
I don't know, but if they do, it's kind of pointless to be in rehab if you're sneaking out anyway.
Yeah, but he didn't check himself in, I don't think. It was his mom, I think.
Yeah, his mom put him in there.
Yeah. So I don't know if the desire to get better was, like, even there for him.
No, I think he was getting better. I saw improvement. Well, I didn't
know he was really like, getting better, but it was, like, his mom originally.
Yeah. So,
oh. Oh wait, how did you feel about that? What's her name? Hattie.
Who?
I can't remember. What is Roger's ex-girlfriend's name?
Hattie? No, it wasn't anything like that. It was like, okay, hold on. I'm at the point where they're talking about Lucien. Yo, I want to go to the Brown Hotel, to be honest.
The what?
The Brown Hotel.
Oh, do they serve that food? Yeah, that like, as a vegan, I was, like, really hungry when I was, like, eating that part.
You can eat the pie, though.
No.
Oh, wait. You're a vegan. Sorry.
Yeah.
What is that title again?
Huh?
What is that in title again?
What's what in title?
What do you eat again? Just lettuce?
No, I just can't eat dairy or meat.
Oh. So you could have the strawberries on top of the pie dessert thing?
Yeah, if it didn't touch anything.
But anywho, I'd like to go to the Brown. Her name was Hadley.
Hadley, okay. I was kind of close.
I did not like her. Like,
she seemed like a B word.
Like, and anyway, like, he was just being manipulated from, like, everyone around him saw, like, she's a terrible person. And then finally when he, like, go for her, he was like, oh, yeah, like, she was always being late. She wasn't respectful of me. She wasn't respectful of my friends. I was like, these are, like, the key points in bad girlfriend material. Like, how are you now noticing this?
And then, like, at the end, whenever he finally said bye to her, and then him and Amy were talking next to the car or whatever, and then she was like, you're disturbing the horses. I was like, what? You're so mean.
But I love the part where he was like, I said goodbye to her. I was like, oh my gosh. Like,
snap.
Theater that, like, in theater we have the saying that you have to, like, draw blood. Like, when you attack your other, it has to hurt so much, like, you're drawing blood for them. And I was like, oh my gosh, that line drew blood.
That was good.
It was beautiful.
I was happy for him.
Pardon?
I was happy for him.
I was happy for him, too. Okay, was it just me? But I thought the whole sex thing was rushed. It just happened.
When?
Both of the scenes. The scene with Michael and the scene with Roger. Especially the Michael one. That's just a bad decision.
No, but the Michael one, I don't think it was rushed because it was just like a flashback. Like, it was just telling us kind of what we already knew because they hinted at it before. That she was kind of using him as like a booty call.
Yeah, but maybe Russian is the right word, but it was just not appropriate. Like
the one with Roger was definitely rushed.
Like the F word, ing away. The grief does not work. Like, it just makes you feel worse, especially if, like, it's your first time or something. Like, it's not going to work. You need to do something that's better for you. Like
no, I thought the scene with Roger was like rushed.
Like, that was way too rushed. Like, all of a sudden, she's putting on the dress.
It's been a week.
It's not even been a week. It's been, like, 6 days.
It's almost a week, Taylor. Like, they went Titanic style. Oh, my God.
What'd you say?
I was, like, I was reading it. I was, like, man, they're just going full on Titanic style.
No, like, she put on a dress and the matching underwear, and then all of a sudden, he's like, I don't want any confessions, and she's like, nah, let's go.
I was like, well, first of all, that's illegal.
What do you mean it's illegal?
Because he's over 18, and she's not. Right?
We can talk about that off camera. I have opinions about that.
I'm pretty sure, right?
We can talk about that off camera.
In whatever state they were in, but like, because I mean, some states have it at like 17 or something, but.
Yeah, the law changes per state, so it depended on what state they were in. They were probably, California's pretty liberal.
Wait, did they for sure do it?
Yes! Let me,
because that's making me question it now.
Behind closed doors. Yeah. Okay, hold on. Okay. Well, I mean, it's implied. It's implied.
Read it.
I'm not gonna read it. It's only, first of all, I think that's illegal. And second of all, yeah. So this is how much it takes. That's how, like, this page and this paragraph is how much he explains it in.
From it, I'm pretty sure that's illegal. Just read quotes. People say their favorite quotes all the time. Just pretend it's like.
Oh no, I had a favorite quote. My favorite quote was really good. It was the one that Cheeks had said.
Who?
Cheeks. Andrew.
Oh.
And it was like the difference between like a knight's mission and like a fool's like lost or something. Like, I don't. Let me find it because it was beautiful. My quotes. There sometimes isn't much difference between a knight's quest and a fool's errand.
Oh, I think I remember that.
That was a good one. But the last sentence is, and before going over to join him on the bed, I locked the door and drew the shades. So this is mirroring what we saw with Michael. So we can assume they took the same paths.
I don't know. Maybe they didn't. Maybe I just thought they did.
But then in the next, after like the little divider, it said bare shoulder. So you can assume.
That's a little inappropriate for people who just met.
No shame, but it feels like they've been together for, like, they haven't even been together for that long. Like, really, it just, I don't know. I thought more time should have been applied. Especially since, like, the way, like, she left things with Michael. Like, I think that she should have taken more time.
Was that a deal, though, her and Michael? Because I thought it was just kind of like a, I don't know.
Wasn't it just kind of flashback, Brie?
What?
It very much so happened with Michael.
I know it happened with him. But were they, like, actually, like, a thing? Like, dating?
They were dating.
He took her out on a date, but, like, it didn't go well between them. So, like, I don't think it persisted.
What didn't go well is when she left after they hooked up.
Yeah, I know that. But, like, is there really a reason for it to mirror the scene with Michael? Because is he that relevant?
I just thought she was making an artistic choice.
Okay, way to go, Taylor, for noticing it.
She was using parallelism.
Okay.
Just had to throw that in to prove that I'm not being intellectually as lazy as you are.
I'm not intellectually lazy, okay? I'm just not of the opinion that every single thing an artist does. As an artist, I would know this. Not that I'm saying a good one. But
I'm an artist too.
I know you are, but I'm just saying me personally, like as Brie.
Okay.
Sometimes, like, I paint a fluffy cloud because it looks good, not because it means like that I want to die on a fluffy cloud or I don't know, some symbolism for something.
I mean, but like the clues, the context. You can infer. But anyway.
That's the only way she knows how to write a sex scene.
What?
Maybe that's the only way she knows how to write a sex scene.
Yeah. Who's written? Who do you think has written the best sex scenes you ever read?
Sandra Claire.
Have you read Have you read any Rochelle Mead?
No.
Okay, try her. I love the Vampire Academy.
I hate reading sex scenes though. Like in
I'm trying to remember what the last. City of Heavenly Fire.
I like had to skip over half the sex scene because I got so uncomfortable.
I cannot wait for what is the Dark Artist's book 2? Oh my god, I'm gonna.
It needs to come out. Oh my gosh, I think there's a spider in this room.
Cause Emma and Julian, I need to know.
But literally, the first book they hooked up, is everyone just flinging around there?
Beautiful. Okay, it needed to happen. An author needs to be bold, okay? There are so many trilogies and so many series, and then they make it happen at, the last book. And it's no. Nuh-uh.
At the end, they got to it. But, literally, the first, 200 or 400 pages, they were, on the beach.
Good. I was happy. I wasn't so happy with the aftermath, but I liked it at the time.
Oh, my gosh. What was his name? The evil... Wait, no. Spoilers. We can't be spoiling these. Oops.
I feel bad if anyone watches this and is like, I'm going to be talking about Amy and Roger's epic detour, and then they just get spoiled for Lady Midnight while they're here. It's, unfair.
Oops. Wow. But, oh, yeah, if you're watching, you can use the hashtag PVA Amy and Roger. And we will be answering your questions. Probably should have said that at the beginning. And we'll be answering those on Twitter. You can do that. Let me just look it up.
I couldn't even do that if I wanted to. I don't have a Twitter.
That's hashtag PVA Amy and Roger. No caps. Okay. But, oh my gosh, the whole dad element, that's kind of what made it so sad.
Yeah, that was really sad.
It was a really sad book. But after I finished this, I did have an Elvis marathon.
I was weirded out by how much that dude was into Elvis. I'm like, is this all he listens to? Everything is all Elvis.
He reminded me of Jesse from Full House.
What?
He kind of reminded me of Jesse from Full House.
I never really watched Full House except when I couldn't sleep whenever I was a kid and it was just on.
Oh. I pretty much watched all of Full House, I think.
Mm.
I'm just a hunk burning up.
My grandparents like Elvis.
Have you ever been to Graceland?
No.
We should go to Graceland this summer.
I'm going to the Middle East, so you can come there with me, and then we can go to Graceland if you want.
Are you coming back from the Middle East?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Yeah, I'm probably going to be there for my birthday. So through August.
Through August?
Yeah, because we usually, whenever we go somewhere during the summer, it's usually during, July. Yeah,
I'm next to the school year, and then we can't do anything.
We can do something at the beginning.
No, I'm gonna be I'm gonna be occupied for the entire month of June, I think.
Why? What are you doing?
Shreveport. As of now, that's what the plan is.
No.
But yeah, you just make sure you come back all right.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Yeah, better come back with all of your family.
Mm-hmm.
Because if not, I will. Don't worry about it. You'll come back. I have faith. I don't want to have to think about what I'll have to do if you don't.
Aw, you're so nice, Taylor.
Because in America, everyone belongs. We should be for equality, not for dividing people. And if you believe the propaganda centered around a specific group of people, you should educate yourself. Because before, back in the day, over the seas in the Eastern Hemisphere.
Taylor, what are you doing?
Trade had to go through the Middle East. Thank you.
You're my fave.
I'm trying to make a statement about justice.
Yeah, I got that.
I tried spoken word on the spot, man. Next time I'll write it out.
Okay, let's talk about their first kiss.
My first kiss went a little like this. That kiss was, I don't know, it was unexpectedly expected.
I didn't like what he said afterwards.
Like, I didn't expect him to kiss like then, but I expected her to like kiss him. What did he say after again?
He was like, I've been wanting to do that since Kansas, and I'm like,
that's before he even saw Hadley.
Like, no one needs your commentary, man.
I don't know.
I just did not understand their relationship. I'm like, why are you guys, wow, like, this is moving fast. All of a sudden, it was
like this is just too much, I feel.
Yeah, like, it happened
fast when it happened. Like, it took forever for it to happen, and then when it did, it was like, whoa.
Like, it was just like, da-da-da-da-da, we're just driving, and then all of a sudden, boom, and then...
And she's all innocent. She's like, what does fire mean?
What does what mean?
Your friend has fire or whatever. Like, what does that mean? And then all of a sudden she's like, having sex with everyone.
Did you think that guy outside of the party, I think his name is Bradley, do you think he was a pervert? Because I thought he was a pervert.
Oh, yeah. He was weird. He was like, hey, pretty lady.
Yeah, and to be honest, she should have broken up with Michael for calling her pretty lady. Like, she very obviously has a name, and he was not respecting that of her.
Yeah.
Just lessons for a woman. If he is not calling you by your name, that may mean there's someone else in his life. I don't want to be the one to tell you that, but, there's possibility.
Unless he has, like, a cute nickname for you that's, like, your name, but not your name. Like, it's, like, I don't know, like.
Like the way I call Elizabeth Reagan.
Yeah, something like that.
And if you don't know, and you can't connect those dots, then that means you're not a real friend of Reagan.
I know her.
Yeah, I'm talking to our viewers. But, so like the dad was sad, the brother was depressing. When is she ever gonna get together with her friend?
What, Taylor?
Is she ever going to get together with that friend, Julie, or something?
Oh, the one who moved?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. I'm like, huh.
That's like the only thing that wasn't resolved in this book.
Also, like the theater thing, it didn't really go anywhere either. Like, it's not like there was like a play at the end that she was in. It just was kind of like...
Yeah, I mean, the mention. I don't know if there was like a point to mentioning it. Maybe it was to like make her seem less bland. But I don't know.
Because that didn't really go anywhere.
Also, they never, like, I'm glad her hair stopped falling out, because that's what we call bad.
I was worried for her at the beginning. I'm like, you should get help.
If you know that happens to through stressful events, the hair just falls out.
Yeah, but, like, it's always good to just check in with the doctor.
Yeah, like, this girl was sexually assaulted, and all of a sudden her hair, like, kept falling out, so she had to, like, buzz cut it.
Not the girl in the book, right?
No. This real life.
Long hair.
But yeah, so like, I think that's what happened to me. Stress prevents my hair from growing. So schools ease up on us, but only got 2 more weeks of WAP left.
Yeah. Did you exempt the test?
I exempted the first one because I had showcase auditions.
Oh.
And I'm in the Tales of the Lost 4 mic ins. Woo! Are you going to come to my showcase?
Yeah, when is it?
It's in May.
I'll probably come.
Like the first week of May?
Are you going to come to the print show?
When is your print show?
The print show is in March. It's for like the whole art department. You should come.
What day is it? You got to let me know.
March 25th.
March 25th.
Yeah.
That's after spring break. Okay, cool. Just let me know.
Yeah, I mean, there'll be announcements about it when it gets closer.
Yeah, but we can't get those announcements in the black box. They really, we really fix the volume there.
Oh, that's right. You have theater first.
Yeah, I go algebra, theater. And then depending on the what?
You have algebra first period?
Yeah, and at first it was terrible, but now we're like Swan, you know Swan, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes he comes into class and like disrupts productivity, so it's great now.
We haven't and had an actual lesson in like
what?
We haven't had an actual lesson in class in like a week and a half.
Yeah. Cause like Soul of the 70s just ended and he was like a producer for that, so like we're just cruising. He's probably, but we'll be taking a test. How do you, I think the test went okay. I'm ready to finish my part two on Monday.
Oh, I have the test on Monday.
Yeah.
Was it hard?
Because on first period, you have to split it up. I didn't study because I was studying for WAP, so. I didn't think it was hard. I actually thought it was easy. The last test I took, I didn't study for, and I was like, dang, I should have studied for this.
I did a 75 on the last one.
Cause then I already knew the material. I mean, I got a good grade on it somehow. Probably because like the way you check is always.
I got a 94 on the free response, but I didn't do well on the multiple choice because like half of it I made a stupid mistake for like all of it.
Always plug all that in because I just didn't understand the pencils and I didn't know the pencils were gonna be on the last test. But anyway, but what I do to check, I always check. I always plug in my answers. I always go back, make sure that none of these are extraneous, or like if they are, like I change my answer, like. And the thing is, my biggest help for me is I don't care what anyone says. POE, process of elimination, will always be my go-to tool when taking a test. I don't care. Yeah. I mean, that's really beneficial for me with WAP because I'm now doing bad in WAP because of that reading check.
Which one?
The last one.
How many did you miss? A lot of people didn't do well on that.
I missed half of them, man.
That's bad, Taylor.
but for the first one, I only missed one.
I got 100 on the first one, and I missed one on this one.
Well, good for you. La-dee-da. So now I pretty much need to make over 100s on everything to even have a chance of getting an A and do the extra credit.
Hmm.
Because even if I get 100s on the rest of them, I'll still end up with an 86 in that category.
Yeah, but I mean, if the other categories are good.
Yeah, but the thing is, all the writings are going to bring it down because
I'm going to do the extra credit.
The highest you can get on a writing is a 100. He's not going to let you go above a 100 on those. Oh no. She left. I hope she comes back. I'm just going to entertain you until she reappears. You disappear. Wow. I didn't know that was going to happen. So, anywho. So, we are thinking about placing our next live show on, that's ironic.
You froze.
You froze. Like, you were just seeing everything. You said your show was on March 25th?
Mm-hmm.
That's when we were planning to do the next live show.
It is?
Yeah.
We move it?
When do you want to move it?
I don't know. Maybe after.
26. It was supposed to wait. Hold on.
Because, I have to volunteer at the print show. So I'm going to be there late. Because it's like a new thing.
We obviously can't do it next week. Because that's not enough time to read. And we can't do it during spring break. Because I'm going to be in and out of the country. You want to do it on April 1st?
Okay. April Fools.
I'm so glad I'm not going to be at school on April Fools because I'm not in the mood for the foolishness.
Yeah, same.
So we're gonna. So the next hangout will be. The March hangout will take place on the first day of April. Woo! Do you want to introduce that book now?
You should, because I forgot it.
You forgot everything.
I know.
Okay,
we need
the next book, though, because we're out of ideas now.
Wait, but, you know what I painted?
Sure.
Can't really see. I'll post it on my Instagram, just whatever.
Okay. But, any guesses on what the next book will be?
Okay, so March.
Shoot. Let me give you some character hints. Logan Lerman, Emma Watson.
Oh, Perks of Being Wallflower.
There you go. Ding, 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 ding. Wait.
I should have done it.
No. Ding, 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 ding. We're going to be reading Perks of Being a Wallflower by Stephen Chbosky. What? That's exactly how it's pronounced. At least I think it is.
Exactly right.
It's right?
The only way to pronounce it.
Really?
I don't know. I just made that up because you sounded so sure.
I'm not sure. Like, it's literally like Chbosky. The thing is, it's probably in a different language, and it'd probably be easier to pronounce if I understood that language and if it was written in that language.
Let me see. What's his name? Steven? Is it Steven with a V or PH?
CH.
What?
PH. PH.
He's. Where's he from? It just says he's American. It's annoying.
Where are your ancestors from? Because we're all immigrants. You hear that, America? We are all immigrants. What makes
I'm
us.
I'm trying good. To figure out.
If we take away the fundamentalness of America accepting immigrants, we are going to disrupt our ability. Improve as a country. Okay, you hear me? Immigrants are good. Say with me as you're seated. Immigrants are good. Yes, now call the legislature, you know, and write them an email. Oh, and if you handwrite it, they are forced to read it. So you need to just call up the people in D.C. and tell them that immigrants are good and that they are here to stay and we will accept them into our society to help promote growth in our country as a whole. Another message.
It just says he's American. I can't find anything. I've looked.
But anywho, I remember this one point I was forgetting what the male lead's name was, and then I was like, wait, the book is called Amy and Roger.
I forgot that I just was calling it Amy and Roger. I was like, Epic Road Trip, Detour, maybe? I don't remember.
Yeah. I don't know. I liked the road trip they took. I really just want to take a road trip now.
I like that her name is Amelia.
Yeah, like you thought. I thought it would be like. I thought it was just Amy at first, but I like that it's Amelia. I want to take a road trip now.
They went to boring places, though, to be honest.
I mean, they were okay. They were better than the places her mom wanted her to go.
It just seemed like it was more the people they met that were fun, not the places.
Yeah, well, they had connections. You have to say you have connections and you have places to sleep. Oh, my gosh. That was a rude move to cut off your child's credit card. That was so mean.
I don't like the mom.
What'd you say, Bree?
I don't like the mom.
Me neither.
He's just a grumpy grumper.
Yeah. Are you going to think of anything? Oh, okay. That was my dad, in case you didn't. Yeah.
Okay. So, are we good?
Are we good?
I don't know. We already announced the other book. Usually we do that at the end, so I was kind of confused.
I feel like, OK, Okay, so we talked about how, like, the relationship was way too quick. We talked about the dad. We talked about the brother. We talked about the friend. We talked about the mother. Yeah, I think we're all done. Ooh, do you wanna cast the list?
Yes.
Okay. Amy, because I only know one redhead right now, I'm gonna say Kat McNamara.
I don't wanna do Bella Thorne because Bella Thorne looks like a mean person and Amy's too nice.
Oh my god, did you see Bella Thorne in the BFG?
I saw her in the Duff.
Oh, that's what it's called, the Duff.
She is the big friendly giant. What's wrong with
you? Trying to connect, like, I was like, big, fat, large. Duff means definitely ugly, fat friend. I was trying to, like, figure out which book had an acronym in it. But she was mean in the Duff, so I'm putting Kat McNamara in there until I can find another female redhead.
And then Roger is supposed to have, like, light brown hair, and he's tall.
I'm thinking of this guy from this Norwegian show that I watch.
I'm thinking Jake Abel, but Jake Abel is way too old now.
Who's Jake Abel? Let me look him up.
Jake Abel was Luke in Percy Jackson.
Oh.
Yeah, he's way too old now. Have you seen Bunked?
Who?
Have you seen the show Bunked on Disney?
No.
Well, I think the, his name is, I don't know what his name is, but he's like the love interest of Payne List. Whoever that is, he could play Roger. And maybe not. Who do we know for sure could play Roger and is in the age range of a Roger?
Dang it. This is hard, actually.
There aren't enough male actors in the world anymore.
No, there are. I just can't think of anything.
Ya no te veo, ya no te deseo.
I'm thinking of Max Iron, but that could be totally wrong.
Mira Sofia.
You know who he is?
No.
Look him up.
What's his name?
Max Iron. He's beautiful.
Oh, Max Irons. Yeah, I know him.
He's so gorgeous. I love him.
Oh! I want to put someone from Shameless in there, but, like, they're, like, too mature.
I love Shameless.
You watch Shameless?
Yes.
High five through the thing.
I love Ian.
Oh, my gosh. I love Ian, too. And guess what? He's straight in real life.
I know. He's so cute. Thank God, though.
He's never going to marry me. Oh, my gosh. Shameless is so good. Wait, are you caught up?
Yeah, I'm so good. No, wait.
I'm on fourth season. Don't say anything.
Oh, shoot. Okay. Okay, then.
Spoiler part right here. You can know to put it down your hand when I put up my hand. I'm at the part where Fiona just got arrested and she's trying to get a job.
You know about Mickey, though, right?
Him being gay?
Yeah, Ian and Mickey.
Yeah.
I love
that. That happened like season one.
What?
I can't remember
when it happened.
Don't tell me anything else. You're gonna swim me.
But I love them together. Gay couples make me so happy in TV shows. I don't know why. Like Magnus and Alex make me happy. I don't even watch the show, but I go and look up their videos on YouTube.
Yeah, I don't watch the show either because like it's just not how it's supposed to be in my opinion.
In this Norwegian show, Scam, there's like this couple like Isaac and Evan, or Isak. I don't know how to say it, and they're so cute. I love them.
Do you think the guy who played Francis could be Roger if he cut his hair?
I'd love him. Yeah, it's Toby Rugbo is beautiful.
It could work, man. It could, maybe.
He's so cute.
I'm rewatching Rain before I watch the new stuff because, like, I just love seeing Mary's growth as a woman. Like, I just got to the part in season one, this is a spoiler, but, like, where, like, they realized the marriage contract was, like, rigged. And, like, this is the first time, like, she gives that, like, boss A speech.
Oh,
like,
yeah, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
And, like, they all, like, bat her, and I'm like, yay!
I can't stand that Francis dies. I just can't watch season 4 or 3. Like, I can't finish 3.
Like, I just can't. He's too important to me. And then I can't deal with that Condé dude. I'm glad.
I love Condé, man.
I hated him and Mary. I wanted them to die violently.
But I hated that Mary was acting all emotional. Like, she actually cared about, like, she was all for Francis. Like, clearly she wasn't, because she cheated on him with Condé. Like,
No. Let Frary live, okay? Frary is life.
Frary is not true. If anything, Francis and Greer. No, her name's not Greer.
Lola, I'm going to smash your head. Taylor, I hate you.
Wait, spoiler. Did you see when Lola got beheaded?
Yes, I watched it.
Oh my gosh, I lost it. I loved Lola. Oh my God.
They showed it. Like, with her head missing.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna miss her.
So off topic. Okay, we have to keep casting.
We have to what? Oh yeah. Oh, we stopped spoiling now. The mom.
Okay, I'm thinking, you know, the Mortal Instruments, the movie?
Yeah.
You know the mom in that one?
Yeah.
I'm thinking her.
No, she's not mean enough. Oh my gosh.
She looks mean though.
The girl who plays Umbridge.
What?
The woman that plays Umbridge as the mom.
Who's Umbridge?
Dolores Umbridge?
I don't know.
Harry Potter?
Yeah, I don't know. I told you I haven't read it.
Oh my gosh.
I'm reading it this summer. I told you that. We go over this every time, Taylor. every time you make a Harry Potter reference, I have to explain this to you.
It was just so unnatural.
Sorry.
So yeah, I'm casting the person who plays Dolores Umbridge as the mom. Who do you want to play Charlie?
Well, I know his hair is dark. His hair is auburn. Ian.
Yes. Oh my, he looks so good when he did. And he, like, he can play being drugged. He can do it. He can play.
Yeah, he's good at that.
He's genius. Definitely.
Guapo. I love him. Okay. Anyway, who else is there?
And the father. What are we gonna make the father? He needs to be, like, joyful and with you, I feel.
Yeah.
But not like Frank from Shameless you. Like a good you.
No.
A positive you.
I'm thinking. Let me think harder.
Oh, Rogelio! Wait, no, he has to be right. I don't think Rogelio works. Never mind.
Have
you seen The Secret Life of an American Teenager?
Yeah, I used to watch that with my brother.
What about Ben's dad, Mr. Boykovich?
Okay. Yeah, I think that works. Or, like, even her dad works.
I don't know. He'd have to do some he has to, like, get, like, cooler.
No, but he's sufficiently dorky.
He's not like, I don't know. Okay. We can try.
Okay.
Oh, do you want to cast Hadley?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm thinking like Bella Thorne as a blonde.
Oh my gosh, I was thinking that too. We are like,
I don't like her recently. I hear she's mean.
Oh my gosh, and like, we'll talk after this is over. So is that it? Wait, no, or do you want to cast her brother?
Her brother? Okay, he's kind of like big.
No, he has to be cooler than Ben, I feel. Maybe he's more like a Jack.
In Titanic?
No, Jackie took a life of an American Teenager.
Oh, okay. I was like, girl, no. Okay.
Do you agree?
Yeah.
Okay. And then do you want, what about Cheeks?
Drew?
Yeah, Drew. What do you think he could be?
Man, I forgot everything about his appearance. Like, I don't know.
Me too. Let's just say he's Ricky and move on.
Okay, yeah, that works.
Ooh, what do you think his friend could be? Brillin.
Oh! Is your hair brown? I see Jennifer Lawrence.
No.
Like younger.
Not at all. I don't support that.
She's like all southern, I don't know.
What about, no, she couldn't play that. Oh my gosh, Alice from Twilight.
Okay, yeah, that works. She kind of has that vibe.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I was really bored the other day, and I was watching Twilight because I saw it on Netflix, and I couldn't even get through. I'm sorry, Taylor. I don't know how you watch those movies. They're not good.
Like, that's the thing, though. I don't know if I can watch them anymore because I've, like, grown as a woman, like, so much.
They're so bad, and Edward's so creepy.
Like, low-key, like, that's what made me think. At first, when I read the books, at first, I was Team Edward, but then I changed Team Jacob once I, like, dropped
him. Yeah, I'm still Team Edward. Like, I don't feel strong enough about it because I couldn't even get through Eclipse, but, like, I was always Team Edward because I just don't like Jacob. Like, who takes off their shirt every 5 minutes just because? Like, no.
It's not his fault. As a wolf, it is easier for him to transform if he has less clothing on.
That doesn't make any sense.
And his temperature runs at like a 108.7.
Like, I mean, but like, Jacob's the one going after the girl who doesn't want him. Like, come on. Like, she likes Edward.
Bella is giving him some. Bella makes out with him. Bella, like, repeatedly goes
He was gonna leave. And like, she needed him to stay. So he was like, hey, kiss me. And so she did it. Like, he was, like, blackmailing her, basically.
She was blackmailing him and leading him along. Like, literally, everybody's like, it's Jacob. Take off your shirt and lay with
you. He jumped off a cliff to see Edward. Okay. How was she leading him on?
Jacob, save me. Everybody's saying, it's Jacob, Jacob, Jacob. I've never heard her once say, Edward, save me. Edward, help me. Usually, she's like, hey, Edward, would you leave me? In her nightmare dreams.
Taylor, she jumped off a cliff to see Edward. Okay, how is that telling Jacob that he has a chance? She jumped off a cliff to see her other boyfriend.
See? So you admit Jacob was like a boyfriend to her.
No, he wasn't.
But you admit that. We're gonna go back and show this to posterity, Bree.
Okay, no. Jacob never had a chance and he was stupid to think that he did.
Well, he thought he had a chance because Bella kept leading him on. Bella did not have the
disturbance. I hate Bella, but she did not lead him on.
Yes, she did. She's always hugging him while he's shirtless and being like, oh my gosh, you're like your own little son.
No, he's reading too much into it. He reads too much into everything.
No. Maybe at the end when she finally told him no, but like very obviously in like New Moon and Eclipse, she kept leading him on. Like, Jacob, carry me with your shirt off so your sin masks mine.
Taylor, I don't think there's any doubt about the fact that Jacob is a creeper, okay? He imprinted on her child.
That was a friendship. He's like her brother as of now. He's her brother. He is like a brother to her as of now.
Which is even more creepy.
It's not sexual.
It could have been.
No!
And now she's like the mother-in-law.
Okay, well, anyway, we have to just admit that Stephanie Meyer plus science equals wrong.
Stephanie Meyer plus writing equals wrong.
Dang. Are you going to read her new book?
No.
Why not?
I don't read anything she writes.
You didn't read The Host?
No, I didn't read The Host. I was in sixth grade, okay, and I was in Miss Hanley's room, and I ran out of books to read because I literally read every other book in the class, and I got in trouble with my book club. Because we had, like, assigned book clubs because I, like, read everything and I spoiled everything for them. And so she, like, pulled out Twilight from another teacher's classroom and made me read it. And that's how I know Twilight.
Oh. My dad's girlfriend gave me Twilight.
You're who?
My dad's girlfriend.
Hmm.
But yeah. So, are we done with this, and then we can talk later a little bit?
Yeah. Can I call you back, though? Because I'm kind of hungry.
What'd you say?
I'm kind of hungry, so can I, like, go eat, and then I'll call you back?
Wait, hold on. I'm Taylor.
I'm Bree.
Bye.
Bye.